Welcome to Office 2013 video project number 15. Hey, in this video, we're going to see how to create a letterhead, save as a template, and create a business letter. Now, I've already opened up a blank Word document and saved my file as letterhead.docx. If I F12, you can see we've saved it. There's our file path right to our class notes Word folder. Now, we're going to first create a letterhead. That just means we have our business name, address, email, and maybe some sort of graphic up at the top. And we want to save it as a template so we always have it anytime we're typing a letter that we're going to print out. All right, so I'm going to type business 216 team. That's our business name. Enter. I have two enters there. Now I'm going to insert a picture. I'm going to go up to Insert, Online Pictures, and type graduation, enter. I'm going to pick a picture like this and double click, or triple click, it wants me to, broop, there we go. I'm going to resize it, point to the corner. All right, now I'm going to come to the end, you know, and if you have the picture highlighted, you can hit the END key, end, and you can see your cursor flashing. Now type a space. We're in building 29, fall quarter 2013. You put whatever quarter you're in. And then Highline Community College. I have my HCC space. That's our autocorrect. All right, so that is going to be our address. Normally, you'd put an address, a telephone number, an email, or something like that. I'm going to hit another Enter. Now, before we save this as a template, I want to add a line. Now, there's a bunch of ways you can add a line, and most of them are not correct or inefficient. You don't want to go up to Insert Shapes, and I know some of us are laughing because some of us have done this. I certainly did this years ago. That is not a good way. If we change the margins or something, that won't update. Control-Z. We definitely don't want to highlight the whole line and do underline Control-U. That doesn't work either. It doesn't go all the way to the margin. Control-Z. The way to do this is do paragraph level border. Now, I hit two enters before I did this because it's a paragraph level format. And if you hit enter, the border carries forward. So now I have my cursor in that paragraph. Boop. If it's not the particular bottom border, then select from the dropdown. And there we have it. And that'll change with the margins. Alt-PSP, 0.5 tab, enter. Wow, that's pretty cool. So that's an efficient border for our letterhead. Now I'm going to Control-Z. Now we want to do two things before we save as a letterhead. And actually, I forgot. I didn't want this funky default paragraph setting. So I'm going to highlight all of this, right-click paragraph. I'm going to change it to single and no space after. Notice because I'm doing paragraph level formatting and I wanted to do multiple paragraphs, I had to highlight them all. So there we have our single spacing. Let's also make this increase the font. I'm going to control close square bracket, maybe go up to 22, and control B. All right, so we have a letterhead. Control S, we've saved the .docx. Now we want to save as a template. Save as, and the template will do something absolutely wonderful for us. I'm going to change, I have the location. I'm going to change it to .dot for template. There's an X and M, and then the earlier version, 2003 before, was just .. I'm going to save it to .x. There we go, a Word template. Oh, wait a second. It's trying to push me to the default location for templates. I'm not going to let it. I'm going to drill down, class notes Word. So where do you want to save it? What do you want to call it? And the extension we changed to .dotx. I'm going to click Save. Now, there's the .dotx. Let's close this, go over to Windows Explorer. There's our docx, but our T is going to do something amazing. Whenever I open this, the actual template will remain here, and it will open up in a new Word document that's never been saved before. That's awesome, because that means we can open it up and we're not going to actually type a letter and Control S and save over our template. So when I double click it, look at that up in the title bar. It's so polite. Document 1. Now I can immediately F12 to save as, and I can call it whatever I want. This is going to be called Letter to Jack. Absolutely not the right location. I'm going to drill down. Where do you want to save it? Word class notes. What do you want to call it? Letter to Jack. What's the file extension? .docx. Save. All right, now, so our business letter. Our textbook is kind of nice. It gives us some general guidelines for spacing and tabs. You know, if you go and look at business letters, they're all over the map. People do all sorts of different things. But this book gives us nice guideline. For the date below the letterhead, 2 to 6, we're going to use, I'm going to hit Enter and just use 2 hard returns. Now, this is where we need to set a tab. 3.5 inches for this particular style in the textbook. And then when we set it, as we carry our paragraphs forward, when we get down to the signature line and our name, we'll hit Tab, and the tab will be set at 3.5. Now, we learned last video how to do it. We literally, since it's a left up there, we can just come up here and click on the 3.5 here. Boop, 3.5. There's that little L, Alt-O-T to check. Sure enough, it's been set. Now when I hit Tab, I can put a date. Now Insert, Date, and I'm going to select this one right here. All right, so below our date, that's one hard return. The inside address is going to go 1, 2, 3 to 8 lines. I'm going to stick at 3. And we're going to write the inside address for Dr. Jack Birmingham. Now, I don't remember the address for Highline, so I'm going to go to the internet. Here's the Highline site. Come down at the bottom and select from Highline's website, Control-C, Alt-Tab, Control-V, and point to my smart tag. Boom. Now, Control-Z. We talked about this a couple videos ago. Since paste text only is such an amazing feature, we can use the right-click key. Right-click T is our keyboard for paste values only. All right. Now, click out before the Des Moines, backspace, 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 Enter. All right, so there is our inside address, 1, 2 lines, and we write our salutation. Dear Dr. Birmingham, colon, Enter, Enter. So I've finished typing my letter. Enter, Enter, and now we have our closing tab, and oh no, you know what I did up here? I set the tab at 3.5, but I had a rogue paragraph at the bottom. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. Now it's inefficient. Now I have to come all the way up here with my cursor in that paragraph and click on, boop, 3.5. The closing. Sincerely, and now I can hit 1, 2, 3, 4. And now when I hit tab, that paragraph level formatting, 3.5 inch tab, carries forward. All right, and I'm going to hit Delete to suck that rogue paragraph mark down there. And there we have our business letter and letterhead. And don't forget that great trick with Save As Template. I'm going to Control S. All right, next video, we will see some style tricks and even learn something about sending Word documents to PowerPoint. All right, we'll see you next video.